Hello, folks, and welcome to this intermediate music theory session. This is again a session that I did originally back in late July, early August 2020, with a couple of edits in there. This session itself is about time signatures, odd and simple, compound and odd metered time signatures, with some listening examples and various bits and bobs. It's about an hour and 40 minutes long. You may well have seen it before. If so, you don't necessarily need to watch it again unless you really want to. If you've not seen it, it's a useful session to really take you through quite an in-depth explanation of how time signatures work, both within a score and how we listen to a score and how we feel that pulse. So hopefully you find it a useful and enjoyable session. Hopefully you're enjoying Collective College this weekend, and enjoy this, whether you're watching it live or whether you're watching it pre-recorded, and hopefully you're all doing well, and see you soon. Doot-de-doot. Excellent. So we shall make a beginning. Hopefully you can see my first screen, which is time signatures, simple, compound and odd meters. Not surprisingly, I have a very specific way of teaching this, which you'll find out later on. So before we start, make sure you have a pencil and a pen to write with. Pencil probably less important today, more important to have a pen. In yesterday's session, when we were writing treble clefs and we were practicing writing things, you needed a pencil for when you did it wrong. Again, anytime you try to write your first treble clef, I remember mine was way back when, your first treble clef, as I think I said yesterday, ends up being some kind of stunted little runty treble clef that would have got thrown away at the factory, that kind of thing, you know, the kind of treble clef that Debbie would kind of adopt as a lost cause. Because that's Debbie. She just, you know, she'd be helpful to a stunted treble clef. Today we're not writing any treble clefs, and obviously time signatures are numbers, so hopefully you can write your numbers. If you can't write your numbers up to 12, then go to a different session. We'll start from the beginning, and make sure you got some paper. Now, time signatures. It's quite a bit to go through with time signatures, but once you know, hopefully it will be stuff that you kind of have in your brain. Please ask questions, as I said, at any time. I am looking here on the chat. And there we go, so I can see everything. So I'm going to be really quick on this first bit, because this first bit is pretty simple stuff, but I want to go through it because it just gives a bit of simple grounding. The vertical lines in music are called bar lines. It splits music up into durations of time, equal durations of time. If we did not have bar lines, okay, if we didn't split music up into boxes, like, you know, called bars, when you actually try, for example, a song as long as You Will Be Found, instead of saying, oh yes, in bar 112, you'd have to literally be counting the notes. Yeah? Or you'd have to count every word. Yeah? Yeah. And anytime you don't use bar words, you're like, oh, well, that bit, you know, just after the other bit. And it's kind of that. It's like, if you don't have bar numbers, it's very difficult. In large pieces of music, you want to therefore, and also it's very difficult to play music. I once, when I was at university, not surprisingly, in my contemporary music degree, once was given a piece of music with no bar numbers at all. It was just strings of notes, okay? And every note that was on the page also had no note duration to it, so you weren't sure how long the note was. But then everybody was given the piece of music and then played, but without any idea what the note durations were, and there were no bar lines. You can imagine that it sounded very contemporary, aka awful, but that was the point, because it was contemporary music. I would go into interesting things about my degree, like, you know, like some kind of chessboard piece of music where you had to walk into various musical boxes, and just so many silly things. One of the people in the year above me buried his lecturer underground for half an hour, and that was the piece of music, because the lecturer experienced the music. I won't even get into that. I didn't do silly things like that. I did, but not burying people. I drew the line at burying people. So that stave has been split into two bars. Okay, at the moment though, there's nothing else there. There's no time signature. Okay, time signature defines the amount and type of notes that each bar contains. Okay, first bar is 4-4, as we can see. The second bar is in 3-4. These are not fractions. I know that 4-4 is written with a little slash. They're not fractions. Students get really confused by time signatures are fractions. You cannot simplify time signatures. Yeah? The worst one for students is trying to simplify 6-8 time to 3-4. Because if you were a student doing fractions, you could simplify it. Okay? No. They're not fractions. Okay? So I haven't yet described what this is. Okay, what 4-4 and 3-4 means. Some of you may know that 4-4, you would say, there's four beats in a bar. 3-4, there's three beats in a bar. That's not the only information, however. Otherwise, you wouldn't need the bottom number. What does the 4 mean? The first bar, 4-4, contains four crotchets. Now, if you are American, or you use the kind of American system, you would call crotchets quarter notes. The reason you have a 4 on the bottom is because crotchets are quarter notes. So that's what the 4 is, quarter. Okay? I did say it wasn't fractions, but obviously Americans do use fractions. But you know what I mean. You still can't simplify it. The top number is how many of the type of note is in that bar. So in this case, there are 4 quarter notes in every bar. 4 crotchets in every bar. A crotchet quarter note is 1 beat long. Hence, we say there's 4 beats in a bar. So the top number and the bottom number give you different information, okay? Which is why you have both of them. Again, we need both of them. That's why they don't just write a 4, because when we get later on, we'll realize that it's not as good. You can't just write a 3 or a 4 or a 2 in a bar. It doesn't make sense because there's other types of time signature that don't fall into these categories. Whoops-a-daisy. Previous. Yes. So, 4 crotchets and 3 quavers. I think it's missed some slides. 1 second. Oh, no, that's okay. Now, 6-8 contains 6 quavers. And don't worry, we'll go into all this in a minute. So, 6-8. 6 on the top means there's 6. 8 on the bottom means quavers, because quavers are called 1/8 notes in American terminology. Okay? And if you're looking at that, again, thinking, oh, I don't usually see quavers looking like that. Yes, we get to that. It's okay. 3-2, not one you see very often. 3-2 means 3, the number on top is 3. 2 on bottom is a half note. We call that a minim in the UK. So that's a 2-beat note. So if we counted that together, 3 2-beat notes would be 6 beats in that bar. But there's 3 minims in that bar. Okay? Now, when it says 3 minims, that does not mean that the poor composer has to only use 2-beat notes. Doesn't mean the whole piece of music has to just be loads of minims all the way through, because that would be really boring. Okay? It just means that there are the equivalent of 3 minims. In this case, we would maybe say 6 beats. We need to be slightly careful, though. That is still 3 beats in a bar. There's 3 minims in a bar, because we count in minims, or we count in quavers, or we count in crotchets. Remembering here, the piece of information to remember here is, minims are called half notes, hence the 2 on the bottom. Crotchets are called quarter notes, hence the 4 on the bottom. And quavers are called 1/8 notes, hence the 8 on the bottom. Okay, we do sometimes have time signatures which have 16 on the bottom. Okay, 16, a 16th note, is a semiquaver in UK terminology. Okay, so you can have that, but again, just to let you know. Okay, so that's the first thing, is that the top number and the bottom number denote the amount of beats and what you're counting in. Are you counting quavers, crotchets, minims, and how many? Okay, does that all make sense for the moment? And we're going to go through all of these to make sure. So that's the general broad brushstrokes. Top number, number of beats. Bottom number, type of beat you're counting. Okay? Now, each time signature can be classified into a certain meter. And this is where, like, the words and my explanation of them will slightly differ. In fact, 1 second, I think is my microphone ever so slightly quiet? No, it's not. I turned it back. I was recording myself singing yesterday night, and I always have to turn my microphone down when I'm singing, but then up when I'm talking, and I was just checking that you weren't like, I can't hear him.
He's all really quiet, and he's not usually quiet. Now, the terms duple, triple, and quadruple refer to the number of beats in a bar. Duple meaning two, triple meaning three, quadruple meaning four, if you didn't know. Duple's always a little bit of an interesting one. Sometimes people forget, again, duple, unless you do photocopying, and then duplex makes sense. The term simple means that each of these beats can be broken into two notes, and we'll come to that in a second. So 2-4 is classified as simple, duple. Duple means two beats per bar. Okay, simple means each beat can be split into two. Now, I call this the rule of and. So if I was counting in 2-4, I would go 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and. So I split each, in this case, each crotchet, each quarter note, 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and. Okay? So simple, you split the beat into two parts when you're counting. One and. So that's an and time signature. Okay? Which in itself is quite easy. Okay? 2-2 and 2-8 are also simple duple. Okay? So you may think that 2-2 is different than 2-4. No. They're both simple duple. Because you still go 1 and 2 and 1. But simple, like a 2-2 might just be, I'm not necessarily slower. That would be an incorrect thing to say. But it might be 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and. And 2-8 might be 1 and 2 and 1 and 2. It's still the same. So the 2 on the top means it's duple. And you'll notice that we've had a 4, a 2 and an 8. And we'll get to that in a second, okay? But that's still simple duple. All of those three versions are simple duple because we subdivide the beat into and. One and two and. You don't see 2-2 that much in music, okay? And you don't see 2-8 that much in music. You obviously do, otherwise they wouldn't put it there. But you don't. You see 2-4 a lot more than you would see 2-2 or 2-8. Okay, back in history, you used to get a lot more time signatures using two, using minimums. 3-2 was and 2-2 was a really common time signature in older styles of music. A lot of modern music, they'd even rewrite stuff in 2-4 and 4-4 and 3-4 instead of using those minim based time signatures. Okay, 3-4 is simple. Triple, referring to three beats in a bar. Okay, so that would be 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and nice and. It's nice, simple and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1. Yeah, nice and simple again. I say simple because it's a simple time signature. Okay, you're probably thinking, well, if it's simple, is there a difficult one? Don't worry, the difficult ones aren't difficult, they're just not called simple. 3-2 and 3-8, exactly the same, are also called simple triple. Because you're still just counting, there's still three beats in a bar, you're just counting different types of note. Minims, or crotchets, or quavers. So they're still 1 and 2 and 3 and, instead of 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and. Okay, so simple duple, simple triple. Now we get to the most common time signature in all of music. 4-4, at least in Western music, put it that way. 4-4. 4-4's official name, if you ever want to sound fancy-fangled in any meetups with non-musical people, you can say, oh yes, I do like music in simple quadruple time. And some people will blink and think, ooh, wow, they know what they're talking about. Nah, it's just 4-4. So simple quadruple time. It has, quadruple means it is four beats. Simple means those four beats are split into two when you count. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Okay, again, nice and simple. Who knew? Music has logic to it. Unless you do a contemporary music degree, then it has no logic at all. And often, no music. Now, notice, and this is the thing where we can remember this, and this is where we can look at music and know what's going on. A time signature in simple meter will always have a 2, a 3, or a 4 on top. Always. Okay? So if it's a 2, a 3, a 4 on top, it's simple meter. Doesn't matter what the bottom number is. Doesn't matter whether it's a 2 or a 4 or an 8. By the way, you will never get anything other than a 2, a 4, an 8, or a 16 on the bottom of music. Would anyone like to tell me why? Why would we not have a different number on the bottom than a 2, a 4, an 8, or a 16? Or maybe a 32nd? Why? Hazel, unmute yourself and give me some info.
Just because of the length of the notes that we went through yesterday.
Crotchets, quavers, yeah, crotchets, because if we're counting in crotchets and quavers, and they are quarter notes and eighth notes and 16th notes, unless you're inventing, and like, for example, you're not going to get a 7 on the bottom of a piece of music, because that isn't a length of note that exists, okay? So obviously, so really, the bottom note will only ever be a 2, a 4, an 8, a 16, or a 32, but you're not going to see 32 very often. That means you're counting in, like, demi-semi quavers, and if a composer does that, they're probably doing a contemporary music degree. I enjoyed my degree, but I'm bad-mouthing my own degree today. It was very good fun. I ate a lot of kebabs, which is pretty good. Although I probably could have done that without getting into huge amounts of debt, but there you go. Now, while beats in simple meter are divided into two, beats in compound time are divided into three. This is the law of Anna. A-N-N-A, Anna. Now you could say and a, but there's never quite time in compound time to say and a in between the beats. Now to demonstrate, we can look at 6-8 time. And this is the one that I said that students always simplify. They try and say,
is 6-8 time not just the same as 3-4?
No, it's not. No, it's not, and we will explain why. Six quavers in 6-8 either can be grouped into two beats, compound duple, or three beats, simple triple. So if we literally did this, we could either do the one on the right-hand side here, this one, would be one and two and three and. One and two and three and. This one here could be one and two and. It's still the same. I've done them correctly. It depends how you group. And yesterday we talked about beaming. We talked about how the notes are stuck together and that there's rules around this. This is where we start to bring that in. So in this one, though, the issue is the simple triple pattern's already used for 3-4. Does that make sense? So there's no point having 6-8 that means 3-4. It isn't that. 6-8 is split into two. So compound, the beat is split into three. So we've got one and a two and a one and a two and a one, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. And this gives the music a completely different feel. Okay? So we would call 6-8 would be called compound because you split the beat into three, duple, because you've got two beats in a bar. Now, this is why I say the word beat, because actually you've split it into, like, you're counting in two beats. Those beats, however, are dotted crotchets. One and a two and a one and a two and a. The click is the count. That's what I'd count the tempo in. One and a two and a one, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. If I converted that back to 2-4, you will hear the difference. If I click in the same tempo, one, two, one, two, one and two and one and two and one and a two and a one and a two and a one and two and that's 2-4. One and a two and a, that is 6-8, and it has a dancey feel, okay? So that's, I was clicking exactly the same tempo, but because I've subdivided the time signature differently, those two pieces are 2-4, a march is in 2-4, yeah? One and two, and I am marching left, right, left, right. You watch anyone march in 6-8, it's marvellous. Yeah, imagine it. Imagine, yeah. Oh, it's like, imagine, I'm not being mean here, but I can imagine, like, the Italian army would look great. Like, you know, a one and a two and a diddy, it just wouldn't be bad, would it? Do you know what I mean? It would be a dance, yeah? If you turned that into, and you could, because it's in two, yeah? One and a two and a one and a two and a, we are marching off to war, and one and a two and a one and a two. You wouldn't. You'd just dance, go into a dance. So that kind of gives you the idea. They're both in two. They're both duple time signatures, okay? Simple duple, 2-4, one and two and. Compound duple, one and a two and a. And that's why I say you don't go one and a two and a one and, because you can't get it out. So it's and. So it's anna and. One and a two and a, one and a two and a. Or, if it's fast enough, diddly. Diddly 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 do. Diddly 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 diddly. If you ever kind of go diddly to a piece of music, yeah, it's in a compound time signature. Okay? Diddly. So if it's so quick that you can't even go anna, and you just have to go, oh, it's that piece of music that goes diddly 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 diddly. Yeah, compound time signature every day of the week. So, going back. Any time signature with a six on top, here's the nice rules. Any time signature with a six on top is compound duple. 6-8, 6-4, 6-2, 6-16. They're all compound duple because their beat is split into two lots of three. Okay, so you got two beats, the beat is split into three. Does that make sense at the moment? And all you need to do is listen. When you listen to it, it's anna. One anna, two anna, one anna, two anna. Nice and simple. Okay, I love compound time signatures because the music is always a little bit more, hey, upbeat. Okay, although I do like 4-4 as well, I have to say. Some of my favorite music that you'll listen to later is in 4-4. So much music's in 4-4. By the way, if any of you are thinking, what about swing? I'm not going to touch that until we get to question and answers at the end. It doesn't make much of a difference, okay? It does, but it never changes your actual time signatures. You're still subdividing the beat, okay? I'm just putting it out there. It does not change the time signature. It just slightly changes where you put the and, okay? In fact, I'll very quickly say, if I'm counting 2-4, one and two and three, one and two and one and two and one and two and, if I want to swing that, one and two and one and two and one and two and one and two and one, I still subdivide. I just dogleg the and. So all you ever do with like swing is you move the and or the anna. Yeah, that's all you do. Okay, I'm not going to go into loads of swing stuff today because I'm not a jazz man. I'd have jazz people contacting me going, you don't know what you're talking about. You're not jazzy enough. I'm like, yeah, it's because I don't like free-form jazz because it sounds awful. I like proper, like old-school jazz is cool. Free-form jazz. Again, in my contemporary music degree, a free-form jazz quartet once came to to perform to us. I just didn't get it. Well, I did. I just didn't like it. It was like, it was a saxophone player, and it literally was like, and it's like, what? I was like, where's the tune? I want to do jazz hands. If I can't do jazz hands and a piece of jazz, it's not jazz, is it? But anyway, there we go. I digress. So, moving onwards. 9-8 time. 9-8 time is compound triple. Okay? Compound triple. Compound, the beat is split into three. Triple, there's three of them. Okay? 9-8 is like the most common version of compound triple. And it goes like this. One and a two and a three and a. One and a two and a three and a. One and a two and a three and a. Diddly 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 diddly. One and a two and a three and a. One and a two and a three and a. Okay? As opposed to 3-4, simple triple. One and two and three and one and two and three and one and a two and a three and a one and a two and a three. One compound, I just end up doing that with my hands a lot more. Yeah, one and two and three and one and a two and a three. It's a lot more flowy, okay? So compound triple 9-8 is the compound version of 3-4. So one and a two and a three and a. Since each beat is made up of three notes, the meter is compound. So we're just reaffirming the information we already kind of hopefully know. Any time signature with a 9 on the top is in compound triple time. Okay, if it's got a 9 on the top, it is in compound triple, regardless of the 2, 4, 8, 16, or 32 on the bottom. Okay, so the same laws apply at that point. So when it comes to simple time signatures, 2, 3, 4 on top, they're always simple. Okay, if we have a 6 on top, it's always a compound duple. 9 on the top, it's always compound triple. Okay, you might be able to see where we're going next. 12, 8 is compound quadruple. So it's the diddly version of 4-4. Okay? Compound version of 4-4. You've got 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, 3, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. I did this with my students. Interesting story for you. I worked previously in a school called Lutterworth College, and great students. And they thought I was being a little bit racist when I did this, because they thought that my count, I was going 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a, as in a foreigner. Like, they thought I was like having a time signature where there was someone from a different country at the end. They were like, why are you saying foreigner? I'm like, what? I'm like, 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a. They're like, no, not foreigner. 4 and a. No, they got really confused by me. They thought it was some kind of like dodgy rhyme that I was coming up with. They were very innocent children. So 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a. You've got to be quite difficult. It's got, you know, it does sound a little bit foreigner. But then, you know, I'm a foreigner. So 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a. Exactly. So it's compound quadruple. It's a diddly version of 4-4. Okay. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And that's 4-4 that we know and possibly love. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a. The beat is subdivided into threes. Hopefully that makes sense. Okay, and you can tell when you listen to music, it just feels a little bit more, I'm not going to use the word dancey, but it does. It has a little bit more of a different kind of flow to it, and it has a different feel to it. Quite a lot of barbershops in a swung 12-8. Again, so so we get quite a bit of barbershoppers in a swung 12-8. I will try and touch a little bit on swing later on in some question and answer stuff that we go through. Again, as it says here, each beat is made up of three notes. Meter is compound, and there's four of those beats. Any time signature with a 12 on the top is compound quadruple. Doesn't matter whether it's 2, 4, 8, 16, or 32 on the bottom. It's still compound quadruple. So all the different numbers you sometimes see, you can really simply break it down. Okay? Now, we're going to actually listen to some pieces of music. Okay, just before we listen to some pieces of music, are there any questions? Is there anything? Because I didn't want to go through that too slowly, but I don't want to have gone through it too fast. Really, we can break this down into if it's a 2, a 3, or a 4, always simple time. Okay, you split it into and. 1 and 2 and, 1 and 2 and 3 and, or 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So 2, 3, 4. You just put and in between each number. If it's a 6, a 9, or a 12, they are all anna time signatures. 6 is 1 anna, 2 anna, compound duple, 1 anna, 2 anna. 6, sorry, 9, 1 anna, 2 anna, 3 anna. Okay, that's compound quadruple. 12, 1 anna, 2 anna, 3 anna, 4 anna. There. Now we there have 2, 3, 4, 6, 9, 12. We're missing some numbers. 2, 3, 4, 6, 9, 12. We'll find out about those numbers later, because we are going to focus on the numbers we haven't gone through yet. The top numbers of 5, 7, 8, 10, and 11. That's when music gets interesting. Barbershop is very rarely in these time signatures, just letting you know. If you ever get a piece of music in barbershop and it says 11-8 on the time signature, good luck to you. Yeah, although I'd love it if it did. It'd be marvellous. So, we're going to test you now, folks. I'm going to test you. You are going to listen to some pieces of music, and you are going to have to decide what times, and I'm going to explain them all. We're going to go through and I'm going to explain why they are the time signature they are. There is a couple at the end which you will get wrong. Okay, and that's on purpose, because as a teacher, I don't like people getting 100% in any of my tests. Debbie might get this because she has a music degree. She's really hoping she does get 10 out of 10 now, because otherwise, what was that degree for? Might as well have been a contemporary music degree, Debbie. Oh, right. Remember to listen. First things first, is it and or is it Anna? If you're ever not sure, nod your head, tap your feet, whatever helps. Okay. Listen to the background. Don't just listen to what's in the foreground. Listen to the stuff that's happening in the background. It's not always necessary from the guitar or a piano or drums. You have to listen to holistically to what's going on. And if you're not sure, count the opposite version. So count compound and simple over the top of the piece of music. Whichever one feels worse, it isn't that. So if you're counting to a standard piece of 4-4 music and you're like 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and, nod your head along and then try and go 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a. And if it's compound, it will just go, ooh, that feels better. If it's not, it will feel awful, because as you're going 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a, all the things in the music will be happening at different times to what you're counting. Your nod will be correct. So the first thing is nod your head along, and then try to work out the subdivision of your nod, if that makes sense. So that's kind of, that's how many beats there are on the bar. You can go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and then 1 and 2 and 3, and or 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a, and then when you feel the subdivision, then you'll know whether it is simple quadruple, simple triple, compound triple, etc. I do not mind if your answers are in either simple triple, as in I subdivide by in beat into two and it's three of them, okay, or if you just said 3-4. Okay, does that make sense? So I don't mind how you answer. It's not like I need specific format for this. I'm not going to be checking your answers as well, by the way. So if you write it down wrong and you want to pretend it was right, I'm not going to know any difference. But you'll only be cheating yourself, says the teacher. So let's have a listen. Are we all ready? Good luck, and I believe in you. Question one. Each takes about 30 seconds, so I'll give you each of them twice. A nice easy one to start with. Okay, I'm going to give you that. I'm going to ask someone if they know what it is, and then we'll listen to it again when we've decided what it is. Who would like to be confident and tell us what they think that is in? No one. Okay, Tim B.
It's 4-4, so is that simple quadruple?
Correct. 100% correct. Simple quadruple. It's in 4-4. Now, if we listen to that again, listen to the hi-hat symbol in the background. Okay? This hi-hat symbol is going... It's going 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So you can hear, when you listen to the background, okay, the bass part going... Dum-dum-dum-dum-dum-dum is a little bit syncopated. So you need to ignore the bass part. In this case, focus on the drums. Yeah? Boom, boom, you can hear the hi-hat. So have a listen to that hi-hat in the background, and I'm going to count compound quadruple over the top of it, and you'll realize that it's definitely not compound quadruple, because when you try and count compound quad over this, it sounds blooming awful. Here we go, once more. So we ignore the bass part. Once the drums come in, listen to the hi-hat. Here's a compound version. 1 and a 2 and a 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 1. No, Brian Ferry does not want to do compound time signatures. No, he says no. Tune, love Roxy music. Tune. That is in 4/4, folks. That is a nice, easy one to start with. 4/4. Hopefully, we heard that. Okay. Nice and simple. Not everything is as easy as that, but that one, you listen to it, you get the nod, it's in 4, okay? Now, you could say it's in 2. You could have gone 1, 2, 1, 2. Yeah, it doesn't actually matter. In a GCSE music exam, you would not get marked incorrect by putting 2/4 if it was in 4/4. In the vast majority of cases, because sometimes you can't necessarily tell. 2/4 and 4/4 can sound very, very similar. Okay, so rarely in a GCSE music exam would you get marked incorrect for writing 2/4 when it's 4/4. Okay, so don't worry too much. It's more likely to be 4/4. There's a lot more music in 4/4 than there is in 2/4. And often more music in 2/4, for example, a march, will be very specific that it's 2/4, because beat 1, so 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, you'll get a lot of the beat 1 coming out really loudly. Whereas in 4/4, beat 3 is a little bit stressed, but not as much as it would be if it was 2/4. But I'm not worrying too much of that at the moment. So, question 2. Are you ready? Here we go. This is also, I think, an easy one. Now, I was quite mean there. I'm not, but actually, sometimes people find this time signature difficult. And I kind of understand why. Would anyone initially like to tell us what it is? And then I'll explain why sometimes it's not easy. Who thinks they would like to tell us what time signature that is in? Hazel. Oh, just make sure.
I'm not sure. Is it 3/4?
It is 3/4. It is 3/4. Correct. Now, the reason it's quite difficult, the problem, and don't worry, I'm going to explain now, because there's a few faces like, The issue with 3/4 is sometimes you can confuse it for an anna time signature. Because it's often, once it gets going, you hear the three, and anna is 1 and 2 and yeah, and you could quite go da 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 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and it's in 6/8. However, if you try and subdivide those three beats, okay, yeah, you have to be really quick with your and here, okay. I'm just gonna quickly go through it, and I'll talk over it. So here we go. I'll try to explain. Here we go. Wait for it. 1 and 2 and 3 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 1 and 1 and 2 and 3 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 and 6, 8, you would not be able to subdivide those beats in a 6, 8. We've got some 6, 8 coming up in a bit, and you can't subdivide the 6, 8. 3, 4, sometimes, therefore, especially in waltzes, that was obviously the Blue Danube, most famous waltz ever written. Waltzes can be difficult, okay? They can be difficult because they are often quite fast. So you have to get quite, you have to be really quick with your counting and go 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 2. And also waltzes suddenly slow down from out of nowhere. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Also, a waltz is not, is actually annoyingly written and played because the beat doesn't fall on the downbeat. You get kind of like duh, 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 duh. It's kind of gradually gains pace and stuff. It helps with the dancing, not with the counting. So waltz is actually, sometimes my students find them difficult to identify, apart from that when they know it's a waltz, they know that a waltz is in 3-4. And therefore they get that in their mind that waltzes are always in 3-4, they're not in 6-8. So that one is in 3-4 because you could subdivide into and. 6-8, which you'll hear in a bit, you can't. Okay? Question 3. So don't worry with that one. I purposely said it was easy because I knew it wasn't as easy as you initially would think. Okay? So 3-4 is annoying because it almost seems like it should be like compound 1, not duple, like one compound. What, like one anna, one anna, one anna, one anna, but it's not. So, question 3. Here's another one. Be able to nod your head along with that. Okay, now I'm going to give you that another one. Now the thing is, very bad music teachers will generally tell you something about music of an Irish or a folky nature, okay, that is not the case, not always the case, okay, not always the case. Or that's all I'm going to say. So sometimes, as we said, a little bit of information, a little bit of knowledge is a bad thing if it's not given to you holistically and giving it a balanced opinion. Okay, so let's have another listen. Ignore, okay, the syncopation. Get down to nod and literally count. Now, I think we'll all agree that currently we're thinking, in fact, first question, just tell me, is it duple, triple, or quadruple? Are you counting in 2, 3, or 4? 4, okay? So some are counting in 2, some are counting in 4. Either way, that's absolutely fine. The thing is it simple or is it compound? I want you to therefore count, okay? I'm gonna tell you it's quadruple, but it doesn't matter if you think it's duple, that's not the end of the world, because like I said, 2, 4, 4, 4, 6, 8, 12, 8, you know, I can go around with either of them. But the simple compound thing, ignore the style of music, just subdivide 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and, or 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a, when you do that, it should become clearer. Listen to the background, not the foreground. Ignore the violin. Once you ignore the violins, it should be relatively simple. Just ignore the human violins. One definitely feels better than another. So, I'm going to ask Monique. I'm going to actually ask now. Monique, and it doesn't matter if it's wrong. I just want, what do you think? Do you think it is a simple or compound time signature? Just unmute yourself for a second and be brave. Oh, do you know how to unmute
yourself? Yeah. I split it on several monitors. So, yeah. Okay. I thought a 6-8.
Oh, you thought 6-8? Okay. I can understand. I can understand that. I'm gonna go through that. Who thinks that that is not the correct answer, and who thinks that is the correct answer? Who thinks that's right? Who thinks it's not right? Oh, we have a little bit of a balance of opinion, and that's okay. That's okay, because you've got to be brave and give an answer. Now, This piece of music is in 4-4. Ah. It's in 4-4. Now, the reason why, and this is, again, we need to ignore the foreground, focus on the background. I'm going to count both versions over the top of this. Have another listen. In the background, 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 1 and 2, 3. If it, it's Irish, okay? It's an Irish piece of music. Bad music teachers will tell you that Irish music is always in like compound time signature. No, okay? Okay, they're not, okay? That is, I think it's a reel. Jigs are in compound time signatures. Reels are in simple time signatures. Okay, so like 50% of Irish music is definitely not in a compound time signature. Okay, because a lot of Irish music sounds like that. One and two and three and four. You need to ignore what's going on. But you're still in the background going one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. And so sometimes the stuff in the foreground kind of gets in your head and you think, well, it sounds dancey, it sounds Irish, and I was once told that Irish music's more like to be in a compound time signature. That music teacher, find them, okay, shoot them. By the way, please don't. So I'm forgetting that some of you might live in countries where guns are legal to hold. So please don't go and shoot your music teacher. There's not many of them left. We need to protect them all. So question four, let's do another one. Because like everything, understanding the theory and understanding it when we listen to it, I'm all about trying to understand it when we listen to it. Because actually, knowing it is on a piece of paper does not help us as singers. It's like, yeah, I know what it is, but I can't understand it when I listen to it. Yeah, we need to do that. Here we go, number four. So that's the first thing I'll say to you. Listen, I'm going to play that again. I'm not going to get an answer from you because they begin to get a little bit more difficult at this point. Well, not difficult, but need a little bit more listen to. I'm going to play it again. Listen to the kick and the snare. Initially, the kick, and then you've got what's called rim shot. It goes like a little click sound. Have a listen to when that comes. That will help you with how you're beating this, how you're counting this. Okay? Have another listen. So I'm going to tell you now, okay, if you listen to that kick and snare, okay, what do we think it's in, therefore? Kick and snare, for me, anyway, and this is why if you haven't done this before, it might be more difficult, which is why I'm explaining it, but what do the kick and snare lead some of you to believe? Anyone want to be brave and think, what do they think? Therefore, what are we counting this in? How many beats are there in this? How are we counting? Two. Tim is correct, too, mainly because the kick and the snare. If we think musically, at the beginning of a bar, if we think about music, a kick and a snare, normally in a piece of music, you basically get that in a bar, yeah? You'd start a beat, normally a piece of music, you've got boom, cat, boom, cat, boom, cat, okay? That's what it's doing. Kick, snare. In this case, So in that case, it's kick, snare. This means to me that it's not 3-4. I'm just going to put that out there because initially when you listen to this, you could easily count it in 3-4. 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1. But problem is it's kick, 2-3, snare, 2-3, kick, 2-3. You're not going to start a bar of music with a snare drum on beat one. Kick drum starts on beat one, snare drum will possibly be either on beat two or beat three, depending on which kind of, whether it's simple or compound. Does that make sense? If I was in 4-4, one and two and three and four, and kick, snare, kick, snare, kick, snare, kick, snare, kick, yeah? That's what you do. Boom, boom, that's what you do. You don't stick a snare drum on beat one of your bar, yeah? So therefore, that isn't the beginning of the bar. So therefore, we're counting in two. Is it simple or is it compound? Are we an and or are we an Anna town? Compound. Yeah, this is in 6-8. Compound duple. Now I'm going to go through and I'll count it again. Don't worry if you're not getting these right. The whole point is to listen, to try and work it out. And the more you do this, the better you'll get at it. It's not like suddenly you'll just go, oh yeah, I get it straight away. Yeah. Now have a listen again. It's in 6-8. The kick and the snare help you know where the beginning of the bar is. The kick really tells you when the beginning of the bar is. I'm not saying there isn't music which doesn't have the kick on beat one, but this is a style of music. It's a piece of blues music, so you're going to have the kick drum on beat one. So let's have a listen again. One, two. One, two. One, two. One and two. Does that make sense? So often when you count the correct time signature over a piece of music, it doesn't mean you could count that to 3-4. 100% you definitely could. Okay? You could count 12-8. You could. But when you do 6-8, it lines up better. So if I'll just count 12-8 over the top of this and I'll count 3-4. All those work, but they don't work as well as 6-8. And when you're listening, you're always kind of thinking, what time signature works best? If you looked at the piece of music, it will be 6-8. It will be in 6-8 time. When we're listening, we just have to, like a detective, use what we're hearing and go, that one fits best. Let's have another listen. I'll just count. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1 and 2 and 3 and 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 1. I think if I was doing that, one and a two and a big kick drum comes in on beat three. Normally in music, if you're beating in four, the biggest oomph is on beat one. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Three has a little lift in that, but normally your big beat is in beat one. And that kick drum coming in that piece means that to me, it feels more 6-8. It definitely is in 6-8, but it feels more 6-8 when I listen to it as opposed to 12-8. If you were listening to this in a GCSE music exam and you wrote 12-8 instead of 6-8, you'd probably get the mark because you could be led to believe that, but it is actually 6-8. Okay? Question five. Music of my youth. I like music in 4-4. Club dance music of a 1999, I think that was. 1999, 2000, Alice DJ, Better Off Alone, Signum RMX Remix. What time did you do that? What time signature was that in, folks? We beat it in 4. And was it a diddly or was it in simple? It was definitely simple quadruple. 4-4. Okay? I'll play that a bit again so I can dance around again. It's really, really, really like, I mean, you could not be any more 4-4 than that. Again, if you just listen to the beat, yeah, it's just clearly 4-4. Straight away. 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3. 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. If I do compound, 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2, no! Yeah? Block both of this. Here we go! Feel free to dance. Can't help yourself. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Many a night, dancing with my brother in clubs, the trance music. Yeah. Too old now, my knees don't work. Neither does his. So, that is 4-4. And when you hear 4-4, sometimes you're just like, yeah, that's 4-4. Question 6. Here we go. Then you work out if it's Ant or Anna. Bit by bit. Great piece of music. I'm going to give you that again because it feels like it goes quick. First thing you need to do here, are you counting it in 2, 3 or 4? So split it into the process. 2, 3 or 4. Most of you are saying 4. I would agree with that. Then you need to count over the top of it, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1, or 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4, and see which fits better, okay? Here we go, once more. Once it gets going. Here we go. Nods there. Try both. Always try both. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3. Cue. Pirates of the Caribbean. By the way, that is not by Hans Zimmer. People always think that piece of music is by Hans Zimmer. It's not. It's by Klaus Badelt. Because Hans Zimmer didn't think Pirates of the Caribbean, that is from, would be successful. So he turned it down. And then when it became successful, he then composed the music for the second, third, fourth, fifth, and whatever, sixth films, once it was successful. And Klaus Badelt was his music student, who basically composed it in the style of Hans Zimmer. Interesting information for you there. You know, see, you get a little bit of extra nuggets of information. Hans Zimmer, what a diva. Interesting enough, though, Hans Zimmer uses Cubase, the same music compositional software as me, which means that I should be able to be as good as Hans Zimmer. Sadly, that is not the case. Although I've not heard him sing Barbershop, so you never know. So, what do we think that was in, folks? I don't want to be brave. I'm going to ask someone to be brave and just give us a time signature. Lynn W UK. What do you think? 2? Like just the number 2. So we count, you're counting in 2. It's in 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do we think simple or compound? Is it diddly? Is it and or is it Anna? Folks.
Anna.
We think Anna. If it's Anna and it's 4, what's the time signature? Compound quadruple. Compound quadruple is called what in your notes? 12-8. I love the fact that loads of people are saying anything, saying things, but with their microphone on mute. It's like... That's 12-8. That piece of music's in 12-8. It feels like it's in 4-4. In fact, most kids would listen to that. Students, when they initially go, because it's got such a firm footing of 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, because they feel 4, they always just say 4-4 without listening to the subdivision. As soon as you try and count 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and over the top of that, and it almost fits. But then when you go 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4, suddenly it feels a lot better counting Anna than and. I'll just do the beginning bit of this and just re-show that. Here we go. Straight away, it's in four. One and two and three and four. Yeah? However, one and a two and a three and a four and a one and a two and a three and a four and a diddly 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 diddly. One and two and three and four and one and two. And it just feels better. Okay, it feels better to go one and a two and a three and a four and a, okay? When you do one and two and three and four and, it feels like you're slightly funky chicking in at some points. You doing that and it's kind of like there's things happening in the background which are jarring with your count, yeah? But then as soon as you go into compound, one and a two and everything's just like, oh, I feel like a pirate, okay? Pirate music, not saying it's always in compound time signatures, but often pirate music, because that pirate music in films is based upon like a jig. It's based upon that kind of like jig, go kind of what slip jigs and those kind of things. It's kind of normally bases itself in a compound time signature. The diddly diddly kind of makes it feel a bit more piratey. And that is the piece of music, He's a Pirate from Pirates of the Caribbean by Klaus Badelt. Poor old Klaus Badelt. Imagine that, doing the music for a really popular film and getting kicked out by your teacher. Do you know what I mean? That's just harsh. Hans Zimmer, so harsh. Great composer, though, I have to say. Really good. Question seven. Work out what you're counting it in, then subdivide it. So I think that is easier than the previous triple. By the way, I'm counting it in three. Hopefully you are as well. As in, there's three. It's a three beat. It's a triple something. It's simple triple or compound triple. It's one of the two. Okay. However, when we had the Blue Danube that was in 3-4, that was quite tricky. I think this one is a little bit clearer. I think when I listen to this, I find this easier to identify as its correct time signature. Would anybody like to have a guess? Is it simple or is it compound? So it's in three. So I'm just going to let you know it's in three. Let's play that bit a little bit again. But I'm just going to get you this time. Now you know it's in three. One, two, three. Count one and two and three and, or one and a two and a three and see which fits better. Here we go. It's 3-4. Do we agree with me? That one I think is easier because of the pizzicato strings in the background. They are doing something which is called an Alberti bass. Another interesting word for you today. Alberti bass is where you take a chord and you do low, high, middle, high. Bum 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 bum. Yeah. But that one and two and three and bum bum two and three and there's no way you're counting compound over that. One and a two and a three and a one, because the strings in the background are like, what are you doing? What are you doing? It's not in 9/8 and 3/4. We've got quavers. Doom 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 doom. One and two and three and. Yeah, so that is 3-4, and it's a very nice, interesting information. I've chose these pieces carefully. Who composed that? You're going to get it wrong. Who does it sound like? If I literally thought this until about a couple of years ago, who composed that piece of music? Who does it sound like?
Mozart.
100% wrong. I thought it was Mozart. It's not. It's Boccherini. It's not Mozart. I know, it sounds, I always thought it's a famous piece of music. It kind of sounds, it's not Haydn, it sounds Mozart-y. It must be, no, it's not Mozart. It's not Mozart, it's Boccherini or Boccherini. There you go, a little bit of information you see. Sounds like Mozart, not Mozart. My dad used to play that because he loved his Mozart, but I think it must have been like a compilation album when I was little. And in my head, up until a couple of years ago, it was Mozart. I'd have put, if it was like Who Wants to Be a Millionaire and I'd have got played that on a £1 million question, I would have put £1 million on it being Mozart up until a couple of years ago. And then it wasn't. I would have been like, definitely Mozart. I've lost all my money. So, yeah, there you go. So, question 8. Now this one, I'm going to ask you, there's a kind of, there's an inherent pulse in this one that kind of makes you almost slightly lift off your seat and go, okay, yeah, and I'd like you just to kind of feel that. Have a listen to that again, and it does have a quite a, it has a quite a big, hey, I'm going to postulate that might be beat one, okay? That's because that's when I say beat one often has that a bit of oomph, it has a lift. Okay, and that lift has to be there for some reason. Have another listen, see if we can work out what, if that lift is beat one, what else is going on around it? Subdivide, work out. Here we go. So, what are we counting in, first and foremost? Is it in 2, 3, or 4? 3. Correct. 3. The question then is it simple or is it compound? It's quite a slow 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Is it and or is it Anna? Now we know it's Anna. Anna! Correct. Yes. Monique was like, unmute. It's Anna. I've got it. It's Anna. Yes. It's Anna. Yeah? A 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 1 and a 2. It's definitely, 9, 8. That is compound triple. Okay? Now that is the compound version of 3, 4. So we went from 3, 4, that Boccherini string quartet. And then and 3 and very, very, very kind of, yeah? 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 1 and a 2. It just has a different feel. The more you listen to this music, the more you get used to the difference between simple triple and compound triple. Yeah, that 3-4 had a completely, and I know the music style is different, but the actual subdivision, very, very different. 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3. Yeah, so there. That is, that was an example of what's called a slip jig. Slip jig is in 9-8. So again, compound triple piece of music. Now, with the next two questions are difficult and you will get it wrong. I want you to work it out anyway, okay? Just letting you know that if anyone gets these right, you've been cheating and you already know this information. So I'm looking at Debbie. We're gonna ask Debbie on each of those what she thinks the answer is. I think Debbie's gonna have some internet connection issues in the next couple of minutes. Oh no, my internet doesn't work. Here we go. Question 9.
What would I do without your smart mouth? Drawing me in and you kicking me out. You've got my head spinning. No kidding, I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride. And I'm so dizzy, don't know what hit me, but I...
Okay. I'm going to play that again. Now, initially, what's our thought? Are we in 2, 3, or 4? First and foremost, 2, 3, or 4? 4, some people are in 3. No, no, don't put your hand down, Denise, because if you're saying 3 and some of you are saying 4, that's the issue. Okay, it is an issue. And we'll go, this is takes us on to our next part of this. So let's have a listen to that again. Nod your head along.
What would I do without your smart mouth? Drawing me in and you kicking me out. You've got my head spinning. No kidding, I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride. And I'm so dizzy, don't know what...
Knowing what we know at the moment... That would probably fit into what time signature the best, Debbie? Knowing what we know at the moment.
4-4. 4-4.
Yeah. Knowing what we know currently, that goes, it is in 4-4. And that is not the correct answer. However, that's on purpose because actually that piece of music you could say is in 4-4. It may even be notated in 4-4. When we go into the next little bit, it's not in 4-4, and that's because there is actually 3 beats in the bar. Because those of you who are hearing 3, the piano part, it's very clear. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Very clear. But the 3 beats are not equal, and that it feels odd. And that takes us in a little bit into odd meter, which is exactly what it sounds like. It makes it feel odd. You can count 4-4 in that, but if you were to play a 4-4 drum beat over the top of that, everything would be wrong. All the hits and everything would be jarring because that music, although it sounds like it's in 4-4, is not actually in 4-4. A lot of pop music does this. Clocks by Coldplay, exactly the same thing. Yeah? And we're going to have a look at that in a minute. And then when you listen to this, you'll be able to tell people that it's in a certain time signature and you have the knowledge and they don't. So that one we're going to come back to. It feels like 4-4. If you answered that with your current knowledge, 4-4 would have been the correct answer. So Debbie was correct. But we have a bit of information that tells us why that one might have felt like it wasn't quite in 4-4 and why maybe you thought it might have been in 3. Okay, students get that one wrong all the time. Here we go. Question 10. Count it. Go with your gut. Give you that again. This is very unfair. Don't worry. It kind of has 2 pulses, but it doesn't at the same time. Tim Birtwistle, what's it in? Ignore everything you've learned and just tell them what you think it's in.
5-4.
Correct. That
is it?
Yeah.
Blimey.
Yeah. No, and this is the thing. We haven't gone into 5 yet, but that's the next section. That's the next section of this. So Tim is 100% correct. When I said go with your gut, it's in 5. It's in 5-4. It is in itself, again, in an odd meter. Okay, and then when you count, because again, with everything, it's like pieces of music are not just in 2, 3, or 4. There are other, and I said earlier on, there's music in 5, in 7, in 8, in 10, in 11. Yeah, there is music in these time signatures. So therefore, if you can use it, composers will have used it. This is in 5-4, Mars by Holst from the Planet Suite. It's in 5-4. Have a listen. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. The five is split into two. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. It's a very clear 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And it's like, so there's the subdivision of the beat. It's in two, but that's actually in five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, if I was to go 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and, hopefully we can understand what that time signature is made up of. And that takes us on into our next part of this. That piece of music was in 5/4. Not all music is in 2, 3, or 4 beats. We have amazing music like that piece, Holst by Mars from the Planet Suite by Gustav Holst. Amazing piece of music in 5/4. Now, odd meter is a meter which contains both simple and compound beats, okay, in a combination. Okay, the first odd meter is 5/8. We just listen to something in 5/4, same thing, because the bottom number doesn't, you know, so 8, 4, 2, etc. It's the thing, compound, it's an odd meter. So 5/8, one simple beat and one compound. Okay, the order of the beats doesn't matter. In Holst's example, which do you think he's done? Has he gone 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, he chose to do the latter. He subdivided the beat into 1 and 2 and. So compound first, followed by simple. 3 followed by 2. 3 followed by 2 is our 5/4. So odd time signatures are nothing to be scared about. We don't hear them very often, but all they are is a bit compound and a bit simple. Yeah? They call them odd. There's nothing wrong with them. That's the thing. Sometimes my more gifted music students at school will assume the time signature is changing. So a student to me might say, it's 3/4 and 2/4. So they'll say 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. And they'll actually have worked out. They'll think it's like 3/4 and then it changes time signature. And if you were going to write this down and you didn't use 5/4, you'd have to change time signature every single bar. Bar of 3/4. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Well, but eventually that's going to get very annoying to play. Does that make sense? So odd meter is just an easier way of playing what is three, complex, compound, simple, compound, simple. Stick it together into an odd meter, which is made up of a compound and a simple. So 5/4 is, again, I didn't use the most obvious piece of music in 5/4, which is Take 5 by the Dave Brubeck Quartet, which is every music teacher's go-to 5/4 piece. It just is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, yeah? I didn't choose that one. I chose a bit of Holst because I don't like being obvious. Now, so that's 5/4. So we've done 2, 3, and 4, they're all simple. Okay, we said simple. Okay, 5 is an odd meter. 5/4, odd meter. 6, 6/8 is compound duple. We haven't done 7. So I'm going through all the numbers up to 12. You're going to get them all. We've done 6, 9, and 12. We're on 7. I love 7/8. 7/8 is awesome. It's used in films loads. Okay, I haven't got a clip of it, but I do know it's in films. 7/8, and we're going to come to a 7/8 example later on from a musical. 7/8 is two simples and one compound. Okay, and again, you can be have this in any kind of combination. So you could do 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and 3. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm just going to mute you for a second. I don't mind you tapping along because because I didn't mute you. So therefore, your tap was going in a very nice polyrhythm with my tap. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The Now that is quite difficult to click. I've had to practice my clicking of that. But actually, if you count it out, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, it kind of interrupts itself. You think it's going to be in 4-4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3. It's like, oh, where's the last quaver go? Yeah, it's like you've just basically removed the end of a 4-4 beat and it interrupts itself. In film music, they use this to basically, in a chase scene or something which is tense, because it keeps on interrupting itself, unexpected things happening. So if you've got like a chase scene, like some action film like Bourne Identity or something like that, so like those kind of films where there's a chase scene, you might get 7-8 used a lot. Because dun 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 dun, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, or you can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. But it has that kind of sense of three beats, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and you can nod your head to 7-8, and we're going to try this now. We're going to nod our head to 7-8. You'll be okay. Then you'll be funky chicken, and then you'll be okay again. Okay? Let's try it. Ready? I'm going to count you in after three. Okay? Here we go. 1, 2, 3. 1 and 2 and 3. And then 1 and 2 and 3. And 1 and 2 and 3. And then 1 and 2 and 3. And then 1 and 2 and 3. And then... Can you feel that? You're kind of okay for the first three, and then you're in funky chicken land, and then you're okay again. You're like, okay, it's in three. Oh, what's going on with my head? Okay, we're fine. That's 7-8. So 7-8, it's three, but the last three is just a little bit longer, and therefore it just gets into the land of the funky chicken. Okay, 7-8. Great time signature though. Great time signature adds loads of energy to a piece of music. Okay, here we go. John Legend, All of Me. 8-8. 8-8, folks. Which again, two compound beats. And one simple. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, use 8-8 with 4-4. Okay? Because they both have 8 quavers. But when we talk about putting things together, 4-4, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, and clearly 4 beats. 4 beats in a bar. Those people who listen to John Legend All of Me were already identifying they could feel 3 beats, but the beats were not all the same length. So it was like there was a disconnect between, it's kind of in 4, but it feels like there's 3 pulses. There's 3 very specific pulses. And that's what 8-8 is. 8-8 is 1 and a 2 and a 3 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and bam, 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 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So again, 8-8 is not the same as 4-4. Okay, 8-8 is, it has 3 beats, but the beats are not all the same length. And actually loads of pop music uses an 8-8 time signature, which most people just assume is 4-4 because they don't know any better. Okay? So 8-8 is probably the most commonly used odd time signature. You don't get much pop music in 5-4 or 7-8. Okay? You're not much in 7-8 at all. Okay? But 8-8 used all the time. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and 1 and a 2, and I can actually go 1 and a 2, and I'm gonna clap 4, and I'm gonna say 8-8. Here we go. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and 1 and a 2 and a 3. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. The 4 comes when my hands are open. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. 1 2 3 4 5 6. That's why I can clap 4, but my pulse on 1 2 3 4 5 6 is it doesn't feel right. Okay, it really doesn't feel right, because in 4-4 that isn't part of the pulse. 1, yeah, or 1 2 3 4 5 6. The it's a, yeah. So 8/8 is a very commonly used time signature that is hardly ever talked about, hardly ever known, and people just assume it's like a 4/4. People sometimes think that when they listen to John Legend, it must be swung. Does that make sense? Because they think, therefore, because it's 4/4, but it feels like offbeat, it must therefore be swing. It must be like swung and jazzy, okay? Because a little bit of information is a dangerous thing, because people go, oh yeah, it's kind of in 4/4, but it's a little bit offset, so oh, that's what swing does, isn't it? Yeah. And John Legend, yeah, he's probably kind of jazzy bluesy, isn't he? Yeah, it must be swing, yeah. Nope, it's just an 8/8. So it's just a time signature, okay? So that's 8/8. We now get to, notice that 4/4 groups the measure into 4 beats, 8/8 groups it into 3 odd beats. So we've been through that. 11/8, 3 compound, 1 simple. 11/8 is the compound version, in my head, of like 7/8. Yeah? So 11/8 you don't see very often, but I will go through it. You've got 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and 1. Again, it's like 7/8 in the fact it interrupts itself. Okay, 7/8 feels like it's 4/4 and you've knocked off a quaver from the end of it. Yeah, this one, 11/8, feels like you've knocked off the quaver of Pirates of the Caribbean. Yeah, so if you were to go like da-da-dum-dum-da-da-dum-dum-da-da-dum-dum, it's like you've knocked off the end. I can't do Pirates of the Caribbean in 11/8, but there'll be a way of me doing it with a computer so it just knocked off the last quaver. You've got 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and 1 and a 2. It's like someone keeps on interrupting Jack Sparrow, yeah? It's like in the middle of doing something. It's like, it's like, oh, you funky chicken it. So 11/8, 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and interrupting itself. Doesn't get used very often, but I want to raise it so at least you know of the existence of 11/8. It would be quite difficult for you to work out 11/8 unless you knew it existed, if that makes sense. So we've done 11. I think it missed out 10. Yeah, I'll just, I haven't done a slide for 10. 10 is, so 10 is 2 compounds, 2 simples. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and 4 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and 4 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and 4 and... So again, it's a 4 beat. So 10/8 in 4. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and 4 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and 4 and... Yeah, so you end up getting a little bit of 5/4 feel about it, possibly. But so there's 10/8. You don't need to worry too much. You won't hear much music in 10/8. In 11/8, 8/8, you'll hear it loads now. Now that I've said, you'll hear a piece of pop music and you'll go, oh, it's not in 4/4, it's in 8/8, and suddenly I'm the intelligent one in the room, which hopefully will be a nice feeling for you. Not that you weren't before, by the way. Not that you weren't already the intelligent person in the room, but hopefully that'll make a little bit of sense. Time signature changes. We are going to play a piece of music from the musical Matilda, called Revolting Children. And there is a time signature change in this piece of music. And I would like you to try and identify what on earth is going on here. Okay? There's a time signature change. It's what makes this piece of music so effective. Okay? And I'm going to get into the composer of this. Was a gentleman by the name of Tim Minchin. Kind of a comedian, kind of piano playing comedian singer person. I can't play much of his actual music to my students because lots of it is inappropriate and has swearing in it, but he is a very intelligent, very gifted, very great piano player, really good singer, weird hair, plays the piano with his bare feet, but he wrote an amazing musical in Matilda. Play this piece of music. It changes time signature quite a bit. You will get funky chicken times, okay? There is 2 time signatures used in this piece of music, and he does it so well. Just so you know that music doesn't just have 1 time signature, it can change. In this case, it's genius what he's done. Okay, absolute genius. So let's have a listen to this. I'm going to play it for a while because you can kind of get the time signature, and then before you know it, you'll think you're fine, and then Funky Chicken Land comes in, and you'll have to work out what's going on with your life. Okay, here we go.
She take away my freedom, and we won't forget the day we fought for the rights. Be a little bit naughty. Never again will the turkey door slam. Never again will I be bullied, and never again will I doubt it when my mommy says I'm a miracle. Never again, never again will we leave behind.
Don't worry. It's in the chorus. Not long. Great song. Okay, would anyone like to try and guess what happened in that? What time signature was used? Hazel.
Well, it started 4-4. Did it go to 5-8 and back to 4-4?
Ooh, not 5-8, but it did go to an odd time signature. Wasn't 5. In 4-4, which was the one that I said was often was like you were interrupting 4-4. What was the one that I said was like interrupting 4-4? 7-8. Now, it's amazing composition. Okay, I'm just putting it out there. What the thing about this song is, the lyrics of the song are about revolt, about children basically saying, standing up to authority and saying no. And what can a child do that is worse than interrupting an adult or a teacher? So what Tim Minchin's done in this piece of music is he's used a time signature to absolute genius level, in the fact that he's used 7-8 because 7-8 interrupts itself. Because you're nodding in 4-4 and suddenly you lose a quaver. It just disappears. Okay? So in the we can SPL how we like. Yeah? Now, the whole point, we can SPL how we like. They've just spelt the word spell wrong. So the whole point is they're breaking the rules. And the rules of this is that the chorus is in 4-4. We are revolting children living in 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. And when it's in 4-4, you're like, yeah, simple. It's in 4-4. What are you on about? It's not difficult at all. Suddenly, and it does this at the beginning, which is why the beginning's difficult to count as well. But it hits in the middle section. You've got so used to 4-4, you're nodding your head along. Imagine being an audience, having never seen this before. You're nodding your head along in the audience, and suddenly it interrupts itself. So I'm just going to play that a little bit again, and I'm going to count the 7 when it comes. And then it really nicely goes back into the chorus, because a chorus, you don't want the chorus being interrupting itself. It has to be catchy, yeah? So Tim Minchin knows. Pop song, it's basically a pop song, yeah? This piece of music. It's basically, it's musical, but it's a pop song format. 4-4 chorus, make it catchy, Yeah, make it anthemic, make it kind of all like unison, kind of big singing. We are revolting children living in revolting times. We live. It's kind of almost like rat-a-tat-tat, kind of militaristic almost, because they're revolting, they're rioting, they're saying no. I just love the 7/8 section. So let's have a just listen to that. I get very excited about music theory sometimes. Nodding and everything in time with our lives.
They will become a screaming fool. Take out your hockey stick and you can carry score. Never get in the way, big ignorant. We'll find out where the chalk is drawn. And draw rude pictures on the board. If there is something here, revolting.
Okay, so when I said that 7/8 interrupts itself, that's what it feels like. That you get into a false sense of security of nodding along to a musical song, in a song in a musical. You're like, yeah, it's cool, and it transitions. It goes in and you've lost it for a minute, and you're like, oh, whoa, what's happening? And it makes you feel uneasy. Like, it's energetic. It gives it an additional oomph. And I said that 7/8 is used in like films and stuff when it's kind of like it, but it gives it something. It gives it a real. That song would not be as successful if he'd just done the whole thing in 4/4. So just to let you know, time signatures do change. And again, that's an example of a very simple use of a little bit of 7/8 in an otherwise 4/4 piece of music, because 4/4. 7/8 is a very simple way of subverting 4/4, interrupting 4/4, and allowing that piece of music to have something different going on. You don't get 7/8 very often in barbershop, I don't think, or in kind of a cappella stuff. And again, there's certain types of music which use loads of time signature changes. Okay, there's a band called Dream Theater who kind of like metally rock, kind of progressive kind of rock band. They'll just like add in time signature changes for the sake of it, like it seems like for the sake of it. And they'll sometimes have their guitarist playing in different time signatures than the drummer. So the guitarist might be doing like two bars of 7/8 followed by a bar of 11/8 and then a bar of 12/8, but the drummer. Well, they'll end up at the same point, but the drummer will subdivide those into different time signatures, meaning you get all these really weird offbeat angular things, and it's impossible to nod your head along at all. You'd kind of end up just poking yourself in the eye. Heart was like, but the whole point of that music is it's very technical, and it you never quite know what's happening. I won't play that because even I sometimes can't work out what time signature it's in, because it's not in one time signature. It's in poly time signatures, different players, they're all following the same general kind of, you could click, but all the different pulses and accents are because they're all deciding they're playing in different time signatures. Yeah, but I won't share that with you because it'll make your brain explode like it does mine. One second, I'm just going to stop sharing my screen for a second. So we got a bit of Q&A where, and this kind of was about the time I thought it was. There's quite a bit to have gone through. Hopefully, we're beginning to get a bit of an idea. So, to kind of summarize, 2, 3, 4, simple. 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 5, our whole planet, split into a 3 and a 2. 1 and a 2 and 1 and a 2 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3. That's an odd time signature. 6, compound duple. One and a two and a one and a two and a diddly 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 diddly. Six. Seven. Like the interrupting eight, the interrupting 4-4. Four, four. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah. 8-8. The pop song, the pop song favorite. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2. So 4-4, but with actually there's only three beats. That's 8-8. 9-8, okay, is our compound triple, our compound version of 3-4. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a. 10-8 and 11-8, rarely used, but they do exist. I won't go through them, but they do exist. But then the last one you need to be really aware of, 12-8, which is just our compound quadruple, the compound version of 12-8, our pirate music. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a diddly 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 diddly. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a. Timby.
Hi, yes, yeah, sorry, Sam. The 12-8 has been bugging me for years. The time signature for West Side Stories, Don't Wanna Live in America. I think I finally twigged it's 12-8.
It may well
be. It's not four lots of triplets. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11. Ah, yeah, interesting. That one, I would agree with you. No, I would agree with you.
Okay.
It's almost like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3. That is almost. I'm just saying almost in my head. I haven't seen the score. To me, that would be like 6-8 and then 3-4. It may well be 12-8, but that one goes, it goes 1, 2, it's like da 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 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1 and 2 and 3 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1 and 2 and 3 and 1. So that's probably, that feels to me, it might be a 12-8, but it may be, it feels like 6-8. 1 and a 2 and a 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and a 2 and a 1 and 2 and 3 and. So it has the diddly diddly straighty 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 diddly diddly 1 and 2 and 3 and. So I assume that he will have written that in possibly 4-4, but with triplets in the first half of it. Diddly diddly 1 and 2 and 3 and daddla daddla 1 and 2 and 3 and. So he'll have, but it feels half compound at the beginning. Diddly diddly da 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 diddly diddly 1 and 2 and 3. So yes, that's compound and then simple. It's but that's the thing. That's a specific dance rhythm that he's basically taken from that kind of Latin music that he's then used to his advantage. But yeah, I would say that might be that it's similar. You could use 12-8, but it's definitely compound at the beginning of that without a shadow of a doubt, and then the feeling of 3-4 afterwards. Just to quickly go on that. Composers can write things in 4-4, okay? They can write things in 4-4, but if you want 4-4 to feel compound without changing your time signature, that's what a triplet is. So if you've ever heard of a triplet in a 4-4 bar basically just gives you an anna. So if I was to do a triplet, I was to go 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and a 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and a 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and a 1 and. So that one I've just added like a compound thing, and you can add little hints of a compound time signature in a piece of music by just sticking in a triplet. The opposite is true in a compound time signature. You can stick in a duplet. You can stick in something which basically gives you a sense of, which is possibly what West Side Story has done, is that you can stick in the opposite in a compound time signature to give that sense of and in it. So 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and. You can get that in as well. You're still nodding your head like so, but then composers can and will do that. So if you ever hear a piece of music and you're not quite sure what the time signature is, like West Side Story, America, it is probably because the composer's playing around with those rules. Because the whole point of composers is once they know a rule, once they have a rule, they like to break it. They like to find ways of messing with their audience for good reason, because it's exciting. So America is just, it's just energetic. It has that. It has that kind of dancey feel, and then it has that kind of stabby feel to it at the end of that, at the end of each bar, which is so addictive because it just pushes the music along. Great composers will use all these things to kind of create those emotional moments. So, and again, I wish I was a great composer, but I just stick everything in 4-4 and I've done. I can understand it, I can't use it though. Are there any other questions, my lovelies? I would say you want to listen, honestly, I want to say you want to listen to some music. Honestly, just a lot, and you'll be surprised. Most of the stuff you'll find is in 4-4. Okay. In fact, just before we finish, I will very quickly just share a piece of music with you. Okay. Just share a piece of music with you. I won't share my screen, but I'll share my sound. It'll be just another piece of music just to kind of explain, see if you can work out this one. Just to see what you think. You ready? Just have a listen, see what you think. Another, just again, just to kind of mention, to go through Clocks by Coldplay, another pop song that's in 8-8. So you may well find some 8-8 out there in pop song world. If you listen to different styles of music, you will find different time signatures are prevalent in different styles of music. If you listen to kind of jazz and stuff, you will find more use of more interesting time signatures. If you listen to kind of progressive rock, you'll hear loads of interesting time signatures in that. And sometimes so much so you can't work out what on earth it's doing. If you listen to more if you listen to classical music, you will often get pieces of music in 3-4, minuets and trios and scherzos, so third movements of symphonies, third movements of symphonies often are in 3-4, historically speaking they were, and you'll get these things. So I would say be a listener, and when you're listening to music in the car, always now just try and work it out. Honestly, just try and work it out, because the more you do this, and there'll be ones that are difficult, but if they're difficult, it's for an honest reason. It's because they are difficult. In the same way that when I played John Legend, All of Me, before explaining 8-8, some of you thought 4-4, some of you thought it was in 3, but couldn't quite work out where that 3 was coming from, because you were both right, and that's the whole point. Once you know a little bit of information, you've got to use it, go and listen to some music. You will be found in 4-4, by the way, so that's not going to help you very much. But listen to some different styles of music, and different world musics and stuff will have even more interesting time signatures for you to describe and for you to understand and for you to go through. It is interesting. And the more you listen, the more you understand, the more you'll be able to make people think that you're really clever. And in the end of the day, that's why we learn anything, so we can feel more clever than the person we're talking to.